Hi, my name's Jason Gaber with Mount Baker Mining and Metals. Today we're going to give you a little overview on what we do here. And for more information, you can go to our website at www.mbmmllc.com. What we do here is we specialize in crushing and concentrating hard rock ores, and we use gravity methods for concentration to stay away from the chemicals and the permitting issues associated with those. And basically what we do is when a prospective client contacts Mount Baker Mining and Metals, we're going to ask for a test sample of your ore. And we would like about 100 pounds of your ore sent to us, and we will run that through our testing process on the equipment you see behind me here. And we're going to test for the values in your ore, and if those tests prove positive, we will look at coming onto your site, taking our equipment onto your site, and milling your ore on a production scale. And today we're going to take a little walkthrough, and I'll show you some of the equipment we use. The first part of our process here is we'll put it through a small jaw crusher we have behind me here. This is a Mark 6 rock hog, and the opening on this jaw is 5 inches by 3 inches, so it'll take about a 4-inch rock. It's run by a 16-horse gasoline motor, and once it runs down through the jaw, comes out about 1/2 inch out of the jaws, it will fall directly down into a roller mill located just below the jaw crusher. The roller mill will further reduce the material down to -1/8 inch, and the material falls out of the roller mill into this chute, and the material falls down into the impact mill. So here's the inside of our impact mill. As you can see, it's just an arm with paddles on each end, and the arm rotates at about, I think it rotates about 1800 RPM. It's also driven by a 16-horse gasoline motor, and it's belt driven. This impact mill will reduce the material to about -50 mesh, and the material is gravity fed up out of the impact mill, down this tube, and falls onto the shaker table. The material falls out of this chute here onto the shaker table. The shaker table will carry the heavier material over to the left. The gold will be carried all the way to the left and down these two holes here. These are the super concentrate holes. The gold falls down into a bucket. The heavier sulfides and tellurides, if there are any in your ore, travel down here into the concentrates hole and fall down into the concentrates bucket here. And any tailings will flow down the table this way, down into the tailings trough here, into a prototype hydrocyclone that we have here. And the goal of this is that the tailings will come down this tube here, tailings and water, enter into the 6-inch diameter pipe here. This is closed off, so no water can flow out of the bucket. And the water column travels up this 6-inch pipe and out here into the tailings pond. This particular hydrocyclone will carry 80 mesh minus material up and out into the tailings. The 80 mesh plus falls down through the water column and into the bucket below, where it can be reground in the impact mill. And the water is recirculated through this little pump here back up onto the shaker table and a little bit is used in the jaw crusher. So here's some ore from one of our clients, and he sent us a little extra, so we're going to show you the process using his ore. It's gold-bearing quartz out of a vein on his property, and this ore runs between about 0.5 and 0.6 ounces a ton. And through our process, if we crush it to 90% minus 80 mesh, we liberate 85 to 90% of the gold and capture it using our shaker table. Okay, so here's our three buckets I want to show you after we've run them on the table. Here's the super cons. This is where all your free gold should be. 95% of your free gold is going to be in your super cons. And as you can see, there's very, very little material in there. So as far as concentration ratios go, that's well over 100 to 1. The next bucket here is our concentrates bucket. This is where all our heavy material sulfides in the form of pyrrhotite, galena, some silver sulfides may end up in there. Very, very little free gold will end up in the concentrates bucket. But again, as you can see, this material didn't have very much sulfides in it. So I think overall our concentration ratio is between 75 and 100 to 1. And here's the material that was captured by the hydrocyclone. This material is all 80 mesh plus. And as you can see in here, there's some larger grains, maybe up to 20 mesh even. but there shouldn't be anything 80 mesh or smaller in here, and all this material will get run through the system again to liberate any values that are locked up in some of these larger particles. And the rest of the material that didn't get captured in the hydrocyclone bucket went into the tailings pond. And you can see this material is very, very fine, 80 mesh minus. This again is our super cons and our concentrate bucket. And after the testing process is over, we'll take these two samples and send them off to an independent assayer and get them assayed for gold and silver. We can also do lead, zinc, copper, anything your ore might have in it. Anything heavy will be concentrated out in these two buckets. And this will go off, and this will be our cons assay. The material that comes out of the hydrocyclone will be captured by a container held under the stream for 1 second every 20 seconds. And as that material is captured, it will be placed into a sample bag, and the tailings, the 80 mesh minus, will be sent off for assay over at an independent assayer as well. So you'll have a concentrates assay and a tailings assay, and with those two numbers, we can calculate percent recovery. This is our super cons here, and I just wanted to show you guys the fineness of the gold that we're getting out of the shaker table. Normally this would be sent off for assay, but just to give you guys an idea of what we're capturing in the super cons hole, I was going to pan this out here for you. So you can see here the line of gold in the crease of the pan. There's my finger for scale. The majority of this gold is minus 200 mesh. And all this gold came out of only about 30 pounds of ore. So this ore's running somewhere between 0.5 and 0.6 ounces a ton. And this would be an ore that would be worth our while to come and mill. This will make the land or mine owner money at half an ounce.